Energy systems are really quite magical, because think of all the things we would be having to do if we didn't have energy. If you wake up every day and had an energy-free day, how different would it look? Our lives are so fundamentally shifted by energy. And it has, for a long time, felt that that was a very good thing. The byproduct of that, using fossil fuels particularly, has to produce a load of carbon, which is then going to change our weather systems and cause other challenges for us as a society. And we now need to figure out how we decarbonise that if we want to continue on that pathway. We see this advent of trying to bring in renewable fuels, but also I think we can see some fundamental shifts in the research. Change like this will never be smooth, but in bumpiness there is opportunity as well. My name's Juliet Davenport. I set up a renewable energy company in the late 90s.
The new future, clean energy.
To supply clean electricity to homes and businesses. As we go forward now, we are still seeing a growth in energy demand. 84% of that growth coming from renewables. We're going to have to change the way we use energy to make this shift to electrification. The old energy system had been set up for very large centralized power stations. So it has been as much about the technology itself as it is about a system change and kind of understanding how these new technologies begin to integrate with a system that was built in a completely different world. Renewables covers a whole range of technologies. You've got some of the more traditional ones like large-scale hydro, which are great and fantastic and very flexible, but there aren't that many places you can build large hydropower stations. Next one you've got up is wind. Onshore wind is one of the cheapest technologies to deploy worldwide. And then you've got solar, it's sort of cousin next door. Then you start to look at some of the biomass technology. So that's biogas, which is quite often a waste fuel. Produced when you use waste food or waste agricultural products and create gas off them. And you can use that either for heating or for generating electricity. When you bring all those technologies together, there are going to be periods when, for example, there's not very much wind and you still got demand. And so actually what you want something is to be able to smooth that. And that's where storage plays a role. So you've got obviously just classic lithium ions, batteries sort of that we see in our laptop, in our cars. Then you've got hydrogen, which again is a storage technology. And then fusion, which is the way that the sun generates its power, its heat. It's a technology that's had a lot of investment over the years. We're beginning to see some little green shoots in there. So there's some interesting ways that you might mash all these technologies together. There's a renewables background. I have a vision of, for example, the UK being almost 100% renewably powered. We have 40% of Europe's wind resource altogether. And so my view of what the UK will look like is we'll have probably a lot of offshore wind, some onshore wind. There'll be a reasonable amount of solar, both ground mount, but also rooftop. Now that may be a slightly different view, vision than somebody else in the energy transition. What I absolutely know is I think that we will see one big shift that people don't really talk about, is that the way we demand our energy will shift. We can see a world where actually individual households and businesses become part of the system and actually help the system respond to the challenges of bringing lots of renewables onto it. But in addition to dynamic demand and self-generation, we are also going to need some very big system changes. I think there's a lot of companies who are already in the fossil sector who have started those journeys. This is becoming real. You're now beginning to see that type of investment that I haven't seen before. What I find fascinating is that for a long time we've measured the efficiency of processes through a financial lens. By bringing a sustainability lens in, you can see efficiency in a completely different way. And actually you can get economic return It's just you never saw it through the other lens because you would never think about re-engineering a whole problem. And that is what I find fascinating, is I think sustainability could bring a huge amount of innovation that we just haven't seen before.